International Jazz Day is made possible by major support from Toyota.
Except you don't touch. Back in the day, it just went without saying at all. All the world's history gradually dying of shock. That's like talking, except you don't talk. You sing, you sing. Sing for the bartender, sing for the janitor, sing. Sing for the camera. Sing for the animals, sing. Sing for the firemen, sing for the postal men, sing. Sing for the teachers who told you that you couldn't sing. Just sing.
Thank you. Today we're celebrating the 10th anniversary of International Jazz Day, which was launched right here at the United Nations with our first global concert. I was a host that first year, and it's great to be back. It was a magical evening where I was honored to introduce the beloved South African trumpet virtuoso Hugh Masekela, whose career was greatly influenced by my father, Kirk Douglas's performance in Young Man with the Horn. Founded in 2011 by UNESCO and Herbie Hancock, this noble idea has grown into a global movement. Jazz Day's message of peace and freedom has been embraced and adopted by billions of people around the world. To honor this milestone, we plan to return to New York and present this year's global concert from the United Nations. However, with the world still struggling with the serious challenges of the pandemic, we put together a virtual concert with performances at UNESCO Headquarters in Paris, here in New York, as well as London, Cape Town, Moscow, Tokyo, Rio de Janeiro, and many, many more. Plus, Herbie Hancock has assembled an amazing group of international artists who'll be joining him in Los Angeles. All these musicians have come together after a year of unprecedented challenges. And while they may be physically, ideologically, and culturally worlds apart, they've united in the purpose of demonstrating that jazz crosses all borders, links all generations, and illuminates cooperation and compassion for all. So now, let's hear some music. Thank you.
food, it's far beyond the stars, it's near beyond the moon. The show will kiss just like before, and happy will be beyond the sea, and never again I'll go sailing. Thank you.
is so gratifying to the billions of people who believe in International Jazz Day's mission is that it's no longer limited to one or two days a year. Over the past 10 years, Jazz Day has helped expand local community outreach programs and has been the springboard for year-long jazz education programs. The lessons of April 30th are being heard loud and clear and are being incorporated into daily living. Joining us from Paris, please welcome the Director General of UNESCO, Audrey Azoulay.
Thank you, Michael. It's a pleasure for me to launch the 10th anniversary of International Jazz Day from UNESCO headquarters in Paris. Jazz is a celebration of improvisation, a call for freedom. In the words of Chick Corea, who sadly left us this year, it's the joy of creating, it's a way of life. And today, we need jazz more than ever. We need its values, its freedom, its creativity, its fight for human dignity and against racism and all forms of discrimination. Culture and music offer us comfort and relief during this pandemic. And in return, we must all support the artists who are vital parts of our lives. UNESCO is doing its part through ResiliArt Debates, a series of conversations with cultural professionals and artists to shed light on conditions in the creative sectors today, and including the music scene. This is UNESCO's work, and this is our message tonight. And with our partner, the Herbie Hancock Institute of Jazz, we are organizing masterclasses, webinars, conferences, training sessions, history lessons to teach and nurture the values of jazz and give voice to those who make it flourish. 75 years ago, in the wake of the Second World War, our founders created this organization, this United Nations Organization for Education, Culture, Science and Information. And it's also 75 years ago that Joseph Kosma composed Autumn Leaves, based on a poem by Jacques Prévert. And when it was then performed by Cannonball Adderley and Miles Davis, we saw how jazz could constantly reinvent itself and just how much it nourished us. So let's listen, let's be inspired, let's take joy in music on this Jazz Day. Thank you.
Now from UNESCO headquarters in Paris, singer, songwriter, actress, and activist, Angélique Kidjo.
La Cuchoni Langa Sakubui Komo Nakuntringa Gawe La Cuchoni
I guess you could say that jazz is the original world music. And hearing musicians from diverse nations have one-of-a-kind musical conversations and join together, well, I mean, that's pure magic. And now we're going to Los Angeles to join jazz icon and UNESCO Goodwill Ambassador Herbie Hancock.
Thank you so much, Michael, for being with us again to celebrate our 10th anniversary. You were one of our hosts for the first International Jazz Day Global Concert. And here we are, decade later, together again, social distancing from New York to Los Angeles. Despite the many challenges, restrictions, and hardships we all continue to face, I'm deeply humbled and encouraged and so very grateful that this year, International Jazz Day is going strong and is being celebrated by millions of people in over 190 countries on all seven continents, with concerts, community service initiatives, education programs, masterclasses, and so much more. This is the power of jazz, uniting people and nourishing their souls during the toughest of times. I can actually feel all this amazing positive energy from everyone joining us today. So let's harness it and show the world that we have a viable solution for world peace. After 10 years, April 30th is now recognized as the day where people of all ages, ethnicities, genders, join forces and prove without a doubt that our similarities are more powerful than our differences. Thank you.
I am honored to introduce the Secretary General of the United Nations, Antonio Guterres.
10 years ago, we launched the very first International Jazz Day in the United Nations General Assembly Hall at the initiative of UNESCO and the Herbie Hancock Institute of Jazz. With every passing year, this has been a joyous celebration, not only of music, but also of freedom, diversity, and human dignity. These are the values the United Nations works to protect and promote around the world. Since its inception, jazz has built bridges. Its historic role in the struggle against racism and discrimination continues to unite cultures across the globe. Its rhythms and harmonies reflect the indomitable human spirit that can transcend the limits imposed by poverty and oppression. Its egalitarian emphasis on improvisation gives musicians the freedom to create as individuals while performing as part of a symbiotic community of sound. We can all share in the joy and challenge of this unique art form. Today, amid a global pandemic, performers and workers dependent on the creative arts are suffering. It is important that we restore our vibrant societies as safely, equitably, and quickly as possible. On this day, we are reminded how jazz can provide hope, healing, and energy as we work to build a better and more peaceful world. For the past decade, UNESCO has proclaimed this Jazz Day message across the globe. On this 10th anniversary, let us join again to celebrate the spirit and the values of jazz.
Abantwana be kula bazali babom wowo ninyala matutelo kusekuta posi yakona xa abazali be kula abantwana bancini abancini linyala elo mani kusekuta posi yakona xa abantwana be kula bazali babom abazali babo linyala elo mani kusekuta posi Kona ka abantwa na be kula masali babom wowo linyala bantu. Kusekuta posi ya kona ka abantwa na be kula masali babom abasali babo linyala elo mani kuseku. Abazali be kula abantwana bancinci bancinci linye wo lilo nomathemba ye ye wo 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 lilo mama ye wo lila ye wo lilo mama ye 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 ni ye ke ni ye ke ni wo lilo mama masho ye 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 na sho hele ne ne sho hele ne ne sho wo lilo ne sho hembe biso sho Mama, yeah, mama, send a dead.
Pelela, 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 p
Today, we're shining a spotlight on the ethics of jazz and illuminating its social and global impact. As you've seen and heard, jazz plays an invaluable role as a cultural ambassador where everyone has the freedom to express creativity without judgment while encouraging dialogue, combating discrimination, and promoting human dignity. In 2018, Jazz Day's host city was St. Petersburg, and we're now heading over to Moscow to hear saxophonist Igor Bootman perform with trumpet player Till Brunner from Germany.
Hi, everyone. I am Till Brunner.
And I'm Igor Bootman.
And Jazz Day is here. And against all odds, we'd like to celebrate the most universal language on the planet today.
The jazz music, and the music that unites us, music make us happy, make us healthier. After vaccination, only jazz can provide the best health for you.
Absolutely. Ask your local doctor.
Great to see you guys. Soon.
Very soon.
Thank you. St. Louis blues, just as blue as I can be. Yeah.
everybody. This is Jacob Collier here. I'm calling from London, England, and I wanted to wish you all a massively happy International Jazz Day. Hope you're having a good one. And I also wanted to say an enormous thank you and hello to the legendary Herbie Hancock. Herbie, if you're watching, love you so much. And thank you for everything that you continue to do for us as human beings on this planet. I wanted to play a song for all of you, which is one of my most favourite jazz standards of all time. And I'm going to start it in E-flat, and we'll see where we end up. And this is a song called Someone to Watch Over Me. Thank you.
New York City is home to many of the finest jazz artists in the world. So now let's head to Midtown Manhattan and hear some great music. Thank you.
soft and mellow, soothing and slow, strains of a mellow cello when lights are low. Dear, we're so close together, I love you so. Tell me why, think about that weather when those lights are low. Two hearts reveal you, music of chance. Life so appealing with inspiration in your arms. Our lips touching soft and tender, love's all aglow. Tell me why, shouldn't we surrender when those lights are low?
Lights are low, yes, when the lights are low. It's an honour to be part of the International Jazz Day 10th anniversary celebration, and particularly tonight's global all-star concert. I've been lucky enough to be part of three previous concerts at the White House, in St. Petersburg, Russia, and in 2019 in Melbourne and Sydney, Australia, as co-artistic director. Now, of course, the ongoing effects of COVID-19 mean we can't be together in person tonight, but it's a privilege, through the wonders of technology, to be able to play for you tonight from the Sir Robert Helpman Theatre here in Mount Gambier, South Australia. I look forward to the time when we can all be together again in person and celebrate this music we love so much. But until then, stay safe and happy International Jazz Day.
Thank you, President Carter, and the legendary Herbie Hancock for inviting me to speak with you all today. I was born and raised in Louisiana. There, jazz is simply the rhythm of life. It's everywhere. It's like the sunrise. You expect it, but it's always different, and every time you're taken aback by its beauty. I remember when I first fell in love with a jazz album. I was in junior high, and I heard Wes Montgomery at a dance. Something about it, well, just struck a chord. So I ran out, I got an album of his, and I played it endlessly. I couldn't stop listening or dancing. That's the effect jazz can have on people. And perhaps that's why it has been such an effective ambassador for America around the world, in every corner. After all, jazz represents the best of America: creativity, diversity, freedom. And no matter who you are or where you're from, jazz portrays the full spectrum of life: happiness, sorrow, and everything in between. No wonder jazz has gone global. From South Asia to South Africa, from Mongolia to the Middle East, jazz has become popular anywhere the world it is played. I experienced this myself. The first time I saw Herbie Hancock live in concert wasn't in the South. It was when I was at the Montreux Jazz Festival in Switzerland. My point is, jazz has a long history of cultural diplomacy. That's just one reason we were so proud to partner with UNESCO and the Herbie Hancock Institute to launch International Jazz Day. And today, I'm thrilled to be celebrating the 10th International Jazz Day with all of you. Congratulations on 10 years of rousing performances all over the world. Here's to many more to come.
Let's head over to Monaco and hear from a guitar virtuoso who was with us for Jazz Day in Istanbul and the White House, John McLaughlin.
Thank you. Hi, folks. My name is Ivan Lins from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. I'm very happy to be in the International Jazz Day. Music can save. Music can heal the planet. So we hope in the near future to have the most beautiful music being played in the planet. Should be so good. Will be good. It gonna happen. Okay. Kisses.
Thrive in all extremes of weather. but we cannot live together. We can ponder our existence, track the comets in the distance, but we're overcome with blindness by an act of human kindness. We have ventured
7 years ago, Jazz Day was celebrated in Osaka. And now, here's one of Japan's most exciting pianists from Tokyo, Junko Onishi. Thank you.
and now Grammy and Golden Globe winner, the singer, songwriter, and actress nominated for the Academy Award for Best Actress for her portrayal of Billie Holiday in The United States versus Billie Holiday, Andra Day, joined by Herbie Hancock.
As God shall have, and them that's not shall lose. So the Bible says, and it still is news. Mama mia, Papa mia, but God bless the child that's got her own, that's got her own. Yes, the strong gets more, a holy weak one's faith. Empty pockets, dark, ever made great. Mama mia, Papa mia, but God bless the child that's got her own. Crust of bread and such, you could help yourself, but don't take too much. Mama, 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 mia, Papa, mia, but God bless the child.
Our global concert is coming to a close, so my friends, please keep the spirit of Jazz Day alive every single day of the year by becoming ambassadors of peace. Every year, we close out the concert with Imagine, a world peace anthem that is more relevant today than ever before. John Lennon's vision and genius created this absolutely beautiful and powerful message. So now, let's look back over the past decade as our artists share their emotional and spiritual interpretations of this gorgeous, haunting melody.
Imagine there's no countries.
It isn't hard to do.
Nothing to kill or die for.
And no religion.
Living life in peace.
Ooh-hoo. Now you may say that I'm a dreamer.
But I am not the only.
J'espère qu'un jour tu nous joindras.
And the world will be as one.
Above us on the sky, the mountain.
hands. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. Just a dreamer, but I know I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will be will be as one.
International Jazz Day is made possible by major support from Toyota. Additional funding provided by United Airlines.